Hello, friends and fellow gamers. Welcome to the VIP series. I am currently at my parents' house, as I am between homes. I'm moving house, if you guys haven't heard. So, it might be a bit weird that I am not where I normally am. Either way, we need to get stuff done. And on the VIP series, we have an event coming to an end, which is a heroic summons event for Betty. Now, there is a relay here, but honestly, I don't really feel the need to go chasing this. Yes, I can get some scrolls, some gems, and some things, but I don't really need story gems. This Moonlight Gift isn't that exciting, so I'm actually not going to spend, even though it is the VIP series. We've already gone and got ourselves a Mockman and an Eos from here, and all this stuff really isn't the exciting stuff for today. The stuff that's really, really interesting is the new update that got added earlier this week. A few days ago, they added some new things for, first of all, Void Campaign. We have this planet right here, planet number 6, Eye of Dusk. So if you're curious to see how that goes, subscribe. I'm not going to be doing this now. I'd rather do it when I've got chat with me, and we could all work out how to beat these waves with my team together, as that will be a lot of fun, and I would hate to take that away from my Twitch viewers. But what we do have is an update to Realmsgate. They have gone ahead and made this a little bit more difficult. We're on Void Corruption 142, and we're going to see just how difficult this has gotten. So first of all, I'm hitting some chests. That's not bad. So Magic Dust is coming in here just as standard. And there you go. We got to fight ourselves a Sigmund Wave. They're Divine Power level 1. Okay, so they've added Divine Power to this. That's a little bit terrifying. Now, as you can see, my lineups are a little bit mushed up based on how things have changed on the account, but I can still use my 6 max team. I think I'll be totally fine here. We've got Holmes, Young, Halora, Asmodel, Alamak, Elena, and Freya. So we're going to see if this fight's winnable. If we lose, then we've got to try and figure out what exactly went wrong and how we can change that. But I'm expecting that our team should do pretty well here. Okay, so wow, already that's a ton of damage Asmodel's taken. That's not great. Let's speed this up to 3 times. So yeah, Asmo's already taken Unbending Will as a triggering. That's insane. Oh my goodness me. Whoa, Reflect Armor kills Halora. But now we've got an active skill coming from Asmodel. We've got a few shields here from Alamak now, which is really, really good. Alamak gets an active out. There's Asmo. Not even killing. Oh my word. This feels like Void Campaign. Jeez, this is hard. Okay, there's Phoenix coming out. Sigmund. Wow. Nuking the team. What? Yo! Sigmund, my guy! That poke was insane. And Unimax's damage? Holy cow. Okay, well, I'm going to have to adjust this lineup. Man, are we going to have to go all crowns or something? The only issue we have is Asmodel is not a homeowner right now. Asmodel in the home, make him a homeowner, and let's put his tenants in. So there's our big boy Asmodel, there's Jara, there's Tussilago, and there's Halora, bumping us straight up to 9.3 million extra attack. Okay, now let's go do exactly what we just did in the Realms Gate and see how this team fares for a second time. So yes, we've already softened up this fortress wave, so this will be a little bit unfair to see. We'll go into preset lineup, though, and use our Void main. Let's see if Jara does anything. That's our first test here. What can Jara actually bring to this fight? Okay, already totally got the order wrong. Need Asmo in slot 1. That would be significantly better. But I hate the HP stat here. That's just painful. It's because Unimax hits so hard with his active round 1. We're fine, though. We lived it. And we should be getting actives from everybody else here. Come on. There you go. Oh my goodness me. That hit Penny and Asmodel died. Oh, great CC there from Jara on the Unimax. Does Unimax break free? No. Okay, CC is definitely the play here. Okay, Alamak should finish this with 1 active, I think. As long as that Sigmund doesn't kill us. Yep, there we go. Beautiful. Nice, clean win. Okay, let's go back then. We just learned a quick valuable lesson that the formation lineup was wrong. So if we go to the deployment, all we need to do is swap Asmo to the front. And then I'm going to put actually Halora slot 2. And we'll save that. That should be fine. And let's go fight the other teams. So we'll go back into Realmsgate. And yeah, it is definitely harder. I like this though. I like the added difficulty. It's definitely been a game mode that got a little too easy. I say that as someone who's perfect smashing 140. So if we can find ways to beat 142, 143... You know, it's a good challenge. It's something for endgame players to enjoy. Whilst also, you know, you guys who are earlier players, you don't need to be like, oh no, we can't beat these later game modes. Why are they releasing them? It's just to keep us later players interested once you guys are playing catch up. because at the end of the day, people will quit unless they start adding more things to do, and that's exactly what they've done. We've got tons of new things added. We'll also be checking out the new broken spaces in the not too distant future, so stay tuned for that. Literally this episode, we will be looking at that. Oh my word, great crowd control there from Jara. Now we need a huge active from Asmo just to kill this. Perfect. Asmodel. Oh, I love this hero so much. He is an absolutely beefy boy.
Beefy boy.
Look at that. 250. Nice. Okay, so that's the portal active we can get through here. So that felt a lot stronger that time around. We've got a light wave now. We haven't fought one of them today. Okay, so Fortress already proving problematic. It's typically Fortress and Dark. I haven't fought Garuda yet, though. So Forest could also be really annoying. We do get marked by the Asmodel here and the Ada. So Mark Purify will be somewhat useful. We could get CC'd though. Ooh, hello. Jara CC'd the Ada. That was nice. Asmo, please get a good active here. We need to... Oh my word. Okay, that's insanely good damage. Oh my word. Yes. Giant Killer Alamac with Giant Killer Asmodel shredding there. Really, really clean. I like that a lot. Now, if we get another big active from Asmo, we're going to be absolutely clean here. I don't think they can stop us now. Yeah, Alamac's survival he gives us is so nice. If we didn't have Alamac on this team, Asmo would be dead rounds and rounds and rounds ago. In fact, most of the whole team would be dead. Yeah, Alamac's really a game changer for these kind of game modes. Obviously, when we get more Destiny improvements, it's going to make a much bigger difference. But yeah, right now, we're just taking these fights as they come and still winning, which is nice. So here we go. We got these Abyss waves. We've already beaten Abyss. Oh, and I'm out of Lumino energy anyway. Okay. That's fair. That still felt okay. Now, what have we got here? Backline allies crit. Backline allies crit damage reduction. Frontline allies block. Okay, our block's already really high. So I think if we can save our backliners from crit, that's probably the best thing we can do. So we'll grab that. Crit damage reduction is nice. Now, what I need to do is go back to the Celestial Island. And I'm actually going to put Asmo out of a house now. That was just for testing and showing you guys. We're now going to put Aspen in the house because we're going to go fight the new broken spaces. And Aspen is my main damage dealer. So we'll put Aspen in. We'll put Halora in. We'll put in... Oh, it doesn't really matter. We'll just put in the Amon-Ra here. And then we'll put in our Asmodel. Yeah, because Asmodel's a 10 for some stupid reason. And that's 11 million. Which puts, I think, Aspen all the way up to 17, is it? Yeah, 17.3. Absolutely stupid. We've got a little team set up for Broken Spaces already. I am no longer using Elena in this, actually. I've decided, based on some already communication with my guild, mainly Noah, as we've been talking a lot about this since I've been away with my parents, about what you need to do against these Broken Spaces fights they've added. Carrie is really good, and just going ahead and looking at the heroes, we'll show you in a second, you'll realize the energy steal from Carrie is pretty mandatory. They have added Gloria and Eos as stage 10, and more importantly, Vulcan and Phorcus. Now, Phorcus's active skill is already problematic, and Vulcan hits like a truck, so I am not surprised that Carrie is the way to go here, and I'm pretty confident we'll do a lot better with Carrie than we would with someone like Olivia. Now, there's probably other strategies to deal with this nicely, but you know what? We'll go with the tried and true carry that people have been telling me all about in my guild, so that makes a lot of sense. We've got Phoenix here for some burn synergy. We got Freya, Halora, Alamac, and Aspen. That should be enough to deal with these guys, so we'll go in, see how we do against them in this first fight, and hope we don't die. Here we go. Fight 1 against Broken Spaces, Stage 10. Here we are. With an active from Alamac going first, then Halora, then Freya, then Aspen. Okay, and there's the energy steal, which is nice. And okay, we're good for survival right now. Really, really good for survival. Shield still coming in from Alamac. We've got Antlers Cane on Aspen. The plan is to just go ahead and stay safe the whole time. CC'd on Aspen there. A little unfortunate. That stun kind of wrecking us. Do we need Crowd Control Purify here? That might be something to think about. Unless it's just that they're quicker than us, so they trigger that stun mid-round. That would also make sense. Now, Carrie's energy is still going to hit that Eos, which is good. And we've got a lot of shields now on Aspen. So I think survivability isn't an issue in this fight. I think our main problem is going to be just how much health the opponents have. Like, they're going to have way too much HP. And therefore, it's going to take multiple hits. We had this when Broken Spaces got updated last time, when 8 and 9 came out. like having to do it in 50 hits was considered good. So if you guys see this kind of spike in power and think, whoa, how are we supposed to beat this? Like, the point is it's meant to be really hard when it comes out, and it means that new updates like the Destiny transition and all the new stuff they've added will make it eventually get to a point where it's easier. And that's just how power creep in this game works. Like, they keep on pushing the benchmark of what needed power is required for your team, and therefore what seems difficult one time might seem, you know, easy the next. For example, Vanquisher is now considered something early game players have to do, whereas, you know, like 2 years ago, beating Vanquisher was considered the end game of all end game achievements. And now we have Dominator, which is something even most mid game players, well, all mid game players, I'd like to think, should be able to do, right? You don't even need a team of Transcendence Heroes. And it's just surprising that that's the state the game's in right now. But it's just the way it goes. You know, what was really hard at one point becomes easier. It is just the nature of the beast. Now, we've done a little bit of damage. That's concerning. Like, just how little damage we've managed to do here. And that's just looking at their health bar. I'm assuming the damage numbers are actually massive. We're doing very well. But it's just one of those things. You look at it and go, wow, it feels like we've done very little. But we'll go ahead and we'll take a look at how much damage. Wow, I actually took a chunk off Eos there. But yeah, I think the percentage is probably going to be probably about 5%. Look at that, 37. Like, what is that? Like, that's huge. It's not billion. It's well over that. Is that trillion? 37 trillion damage. That just means these have way too much HP. Yeah, that was 5%. That's still fine, though. I got loads of tickets. So we'll hit that in. And now I'm actually kind of scared to hear what all the fuss is about with stage 11. Because everyone's telling me, oh my word, MK, stage 11's insane. You're going to hate it. Run carry. So let's see what happens. This is running carry, by the way. So let's see if Vorkus becomes an issue. Okay, we do steal Vorkus' energy. Oh, Vulcan gets inactive. Oh boy, we're going to die. No. We didn't die. Okay, that's already good. That's great. So we survived Vulcan's active, and now we should be able to keep marking them, stealing their energy. Uh-oh. Oh my word, that Vorkus. Jeez, look at Alamax health and Halora. They got hit. They're dead. No way. Uh-oh. Yeah, because our healing here comes from Freya and Halora. Or whatever inbuilt healing heroes have. Like, Aspen has inbuilt healing. Uh-oh. Yeah, this is... Ooh. Oh my word. Are you seeing this damage? Dude. We need... Oh! Wow! Okay, that was 8 trillion. How much was that in the grand scheme of things? 1%. But you know how this goes. If you guys have ever fought this before... 1% is nothing, because it might end up just still being less than 1%, but if you do an attack, it takes it from 100 to 99, because it rounds down. So that's concerning. I might need to add Vessa or some form of healing. What healers have I got to choose from? I could put Halora's core in. That would give us some additional healing. It wouldn't be a lot, though. What I really need is the Destiny improvements that give healing. They'd be really good. Like Halora gets some of them. Yeah, that would help. Yeah. It's already looking pretty fine, though. We've got that bit of energy steal there on the Vulcan. Gotta do the same here, if we can, with Vorkus. Come on. Come on, carries. You've both got actives. Good. Okay. Yeah, this is nice. It's feeling a little more consistent this time around. That might just be what we end up dealing with here, that it comes down to high rolling energy steal. Ooh, that hit there from Vorkus. We're still surviving, though. We've got good shields from Alamac. Really good shields. We might need to go with Gilded Purple Fan. Oh, my word. They're dead, Halora, Freya. I might need to put crowns on them, honestly. Crown might be the play here. Jeez, Vulcan, bro. What was that? Wow. Okay. And was that a percentage? No, it wasn't. Oh my. Okay. Okay. Right. How are we doing this then? This is shocking. Okay. So Alamac is needed for shields. Balance Strike gives us healing. Very, very necessary healing. It's going to be like Crown, isn't it? Yep. I'm going to need crowns. So what I'll do, I'll put my crown on Halora. We'll leave Demon Bells on carriers. That's a bit of energy feed. It'll be nice when they resurrect. We'll go Crown on Freya. Alamak, Gilded Purple Fan. And I'm going to stay Aspen Antlers Cane and hope it's good enough. Does he have damage reduction? Armor break, block, damage reduction. Yeah, he does. Wow. Yeah, this is crazy. Okay, let's go back then. Let's go see how it goes. Third attempt. Just try and eke out that extra bit of damage. Might be worth actually switching our 10-star carry to an Olivia just to shrink so they do less damage to us. That could also be a really good option. Oof. Focus is active. Minstus. Yo, these carries are not going to resurrect as much as we'd like. This is worse because we're not getting energy feed. Okay, carries back. Good. But Vulcan's in the air, which is not good. Ooh, whoa, did Aspen just die? Yo, that was worse. Like, Demon Bells is better because of energy feed. Maybe it was just a low roll. Try again. But yeah, that felt disgusting. Vulcan gets in the air, though. Didn't even steal his energy. Wow. Oof. Come on, carry. Mark them again. Good, 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 good. Oh, but because we hit them, we're just feeding them energy. Which is disgusting. So Vulcan's going to get up again, right? Oh, no, we stole his energy. Oh, and then Focus kills us. Darn, dude, man. This is hard. I might need a bending will on the carry, to be fair. Then again, once they're dead, it's all on resurrections. Sugar. So carry's active, didn't steal their energy that time. Okay, we're feeling a bit better here, though. Oh, and then Aspen's instant dead to Vulcan's active. Holy crap. Yeah, so this is worse. So Demon Bells were just more consistent. Okay. So do we need dodge from someone like Elena? Is that the plan here? Is that what we're looking for? Is that going to give us an edge? I will put a Purify of some kind, though, on Aspen. I think Mark Purify against this Vulcan and this Focus is probably the play, just in case we can remove Focus's thing. So that might be the move, just for this particular wave. Okay. Carries I'm not going to worry about. Halora I will, though. So let's put that in. Okay, I'm going to put a Demon Bell on Freya. And I'm going to keep the crown on Halora, I think. And I'm going to run, even though it's against all my intentions, I am going to run Gilded Purple Fan on Aspen. And I hope this is enough. We do lose the damage bonus of Antlers Cane, but we benefit from everything else. So hopefully, the added survivability that a Gilded Purple Fan gives us is enough. Let's see. Okay, carry's already looking good here. The energy steal's really nice. That added Demon Bell definitely helping here. Okay, carry should do actives. Yeah, okay, nice. Nice. So that extra Demon Bell on Freya has made a huge difference. We also gained the damage reduction from Freya's active. And that added bit of energy feed means that Freya's going to put Evolutionary Factor out quicker. So already our energy steal has been much better here. So yeah, it seems three Demon Bells is the sweet spot. I'll take that. Yep, carry's getting great actives now. Tons of protection. And the Gilded Purple Fan just giving Aspen that survival, and we're relying on Evolutionary Factor for the ramp up. Yeah, okay, we lost the carry now. That's kind of standard. But we should get an active on this carry here. Ooh, didn't steal from Vulcan, so Vulcan's in the air. That's a little terrifying. Uh-oh. Oh, Focus gets an active. Okay, so there's our first Vulcan active we've had to deal with. And there's the team down. Yikes, dude. Absolutely disgusting. That all came down to just Focus getting an active. Hideous. absolutely hideous. So do we just have to high roll with the energy steal? Or is the idea the carries never drop? Because that means I'm going to need to E5 my 10 star carry. Because she's only level 100. The intent here is that just I rely on the pure HP coming from Treasure Train. Jeez, Unbending Will. Oh my word. And yeah, that's the mark from Focus. That's us dead. Straight up. We get a buff off, we're dead. Oh man. Mark Purify removes it though. We're going to need carry to come back. But then Vulcan's got an active. This is bad. Ugh. Oh man, Focus got another active. There's Vulcan. Wow, it's so dicey. So inconsistent. Oh my goodness me. If I smash this, it's not going to look good. The best we've managed is the pure Demon Bell energy feed, which just feels bad. That feels really, really suboptimal. I could add in more heroes that give dodge. So drop a Halor or something. Then again, I really like Halor's abilities. I'm going to use Halor's core for the extra healing. We'll see what that does. So send ourselves back in. Just this one tiny switch. It might just be a consistency issue, though. Okay, carry steel energy that time. That's good. Oh no, wait, did Focus still get an act? Oh my goodness me. Really? So you just got unlucky? That was it? That was purely unlucky? I can't believe that. So that was already a disaster from round one, because Focus got hit enough times that he did energy. And that active skill just wrecked us. We didn't steal him with carry. Bonkers. Absolutely hideous. Try again. Okay, there you go. There's the energy steal. Much nicer. Crazy how energy stealing Focus is the difference between winning and losing. Ridiculous. So you have to go this entire fight hoping for the eventual high roll. And I bet you when you get the high roll, it's not even enough damage. Because if you look at how much health the Eos had in that Eos Gloria wave, you were doing like 37 trillion damage. And that was 5%. So I can't even begin to imagine how much HP these guys have. And maybe the idea is that you're just never meant to fight this and rack up tons and tons and tons of tickets and use that many attempts. But like I said earlier, I don't think that's the intention at all. I think it's just that we need more power from our destiny improvements to beat this. And then eventually we can do just fine. Like, I know people like Noah have had a really good time using Giant Killer Geester. And Geester is nuts. Geester's really good at killing bosses. Like, you think Aspen's strong? Geester is on another level. Especially with the changes they've made to Star Expedition. If you haven't heard, they've massively nerfed Star Expedition. So they remove attribute bonuses you have, which is annoying for Aspen, because Aspen relied a lot on stealing the attack of the boss. So that removal, combined with, I think they've reduced the attack of the boss as well, so we can't steal as much. So there's a few things that have made fighting the boss in Star Expedition a little more difficult for an Aspen. Natalie no longer works like she used to, so no running Natalia to just cheese bosses. But Geester, on the other hand, Geester's really, really good still, so that's nice. I've been seeing some huge damage numbers from Noah. I think he hit 2 each of the 16, which is crazy, and that's without sacrifice runes, so that was really impressive. I could show you how he did that in a future video, but that would have to be with the permission of the guild, of course. I'll try and get that information for you, but can't promise anything. And yeah, there you go. Wow, look at that. 6 trillion. That's not even a lot. Still on 1%. You know what? I'm going to smash this. Let's see how many attempts this takes to beat. I'm actually scared. Like, really scared how many it's going to take. Wow. It's loading. That's really worrying. How many attacks does it have to do? Wow. 1,500. Okay, well, whatever strat we used then wasn't working. 1,500 is way too much. So I'm going to go back to the drawing board on that one. Try and figure out something else to beat this. But for now, that's insane. Are the bonuses even worth it? They're not even that much, dude. That was, yeah. So I think for a lot of people, that final Broken Spaces wave is just not going to be worth fighting. I think it's going to take an awful lot of power. Like, I'm there with giant killer heroes doing trillions of damage, and it's not enough. Which feels really standard. Like, this is exactly how it was when Broken Spaces 8 and 9 first came out. And it's only through power creep are we going to be able to beat this more consistently. So I'm keen to see what teams people come up with. And carry definitely seems like to be one way forwards, because Focus's active skill is so disgusting and it's really the only way to consistently stop him. But I'm sure with power creep, more divine power, additional bonuses we get from the Destiny improvements, we will obviously beat that more consistently. But that requires more events giving those things. So the Shishi event that's coming out will hopefully give us more ways of getting things like that. But at the same time, it just requires a lot of grinding in Void Campaign as well to pick up all the different freaking resources we're going to need. So yeah, VIP series is struggling, which is a little scary to think that, you know, you've got an account that's spent thousands that's still having a hard time. But we've even seen in the new Void Campaign, some of the biggest whales on the platform can't beat that. So it definitely sets up that these new updates they've added, these Destiny hero things, are going to be the way forwards for improving the power levels of our team to beat this newer stuff. And it's just a whole carrot and stick mentality that, you know, the carrot's a little further and we're getting beaten by these waves that's kind of forcing us to keep on going further. So if you are an addictive spender, just try and not use this new update as an excuse to spend tons of money immediately. We will in time get the necessary resources to beat this. But there will be people out there that want to beat it straight away. I get that. But I think it's best that people just take their time with it, see it for what it is, and know that in the future, in the months down the road, we'll get the resources, no problem, and we'll beat it later on. So yeah, either way, stay tuned. Hopefully you enjoy the VIP series. I'll see you in the next one. And of course, go ahead, check out some more of my other content, hit that subscribe button. And until next time, have a great week and happy hunting.